Hello wonderful viewers, welcome back to the channel GH Uni Application Tips. If you've not watched any of my previous videos about the admission process and entry requirements before applying to the University of Ghana, and if you're a prospective applicant or you know of a friend or a relative who is applying this year, I encourage you to share my videos to them so they can also apply and gain admission to the University of Ghana successfully. So today we are going to look at the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, and this video is to educate prospective applicants regarding Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology admission process, entry requirements, and their cutoff point system. This video is also to help applicants avoid making common mistakes when applying, such as providing the wrong details or information, be it their bio data, their examination results, or their contact information. Applicants also apply with very high ambitions, such as choosing competitive programs with a low aggregate. So for instance, if my final aggregate is, let's say, aggregate 15, and I apply for a competitive program like Bachelor of Law, which the cutoff point for last academic year was aggregate 6, what this means is that I don't stand a chance of gaining admission to read law. And another instance is choosing competitive programs in all your four choices. So what this means is that if I decide to choose medicine as my first choice, my second choice I decide to choose law, my third choice I decide to choose civil engineering, my fourth choice I decide to choose aerospace engineering. All these programs are highly competitive and should be selected as first choice only. Applicants also involving other unknown third-party individuals such as school teachers, middlemen, cafe attendants, and university staffs. So as a prospective applicant, you should be cautious of these unknown individuals who approach you, or you approaching them to assist you in gaining admission at a fee whatsoever. You should rather deem it upon yourself to visit the official university website or contact the admissions unit of the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology for any assistance needed. Projected applicants to the university is set to double this year, 2020, due to the free SHS initiative by the government. The University of Science and Technology received a total application of over 50,000 as of last academic year, and this year is expected to double to 60 or 70,000. So prospective applicants should be well informed about the university requirements and selection process before applying. So moving on to the minimum entry requirements of the University of Science and Technology, and it says you need at least a credit pass, grade C6, in all your core subjects, be it English, mathematics, and integrated science, with any three elective subjects to read any bachelor's degree program. So the implication is that if you have a D7, E8 or F9 in your core English, mathematics and integrated sciences, automatically you are disqualified for a bachelor's degree program. However, for arts and business programs, a better grade in social studies shall be used in place of integrated science, provided the applicant has a minimum of a C6 in integrated science. So what this means is that if you're a general arts or a business student and you apply for an arts related program such as BA Political Studies, if you have a better grade in your social studies than your integrated science, which you still need at least a C6, your social studies will be used with your English and mathematics to calculate your final aggregate. And also, to qualify for a degree program, your aggregate should not be more than 24. So applicants should also take note of this. To read a diploma program, you need passes A1 to D7 in 5 subjects comprising 3 core subjects, that is English language, integrated science, and mathematics plus 2 elective subjects. Moving on, we are going to look at how the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology interprets its WASSCE and SSCE results. So the WASSCE grade A1 is the same as SSCE grade A and has a value of 1. The WASSCE grade B2 is the same as SSCE grade B and has a value of 2. The WASSCE grade B3 is the same as SSCE grade C and has a value of 3. The WASSCE grade C4 is the same as SSC grade D and has a value of 4. The WASSCE grade C5 is the same as SSC grade D and has a value of 4. The WASSCE grade C6 is the same as SSC grade D and has a value of 4. So as indicated earlier, you should take note that the University of Science and Technology does not accept D7, E8 and F9 for any admission purpose. So moving on, this is an example of a WAEC result slip with a home economics background and how the University of Science and Technology calculates to get its final aggregate. Starting with the core subjects, the social studies is a grade B3, the English language is a grade B3, core mathematics is a C5, integrated science is a B3, biology C6, food and nutrition B3, management in living B3, general knowledge and arts A1. So using the minimum entry requirements, the university is going to pick the English, the core maths, the integrated science and 3 electives. So when you add this up, the final aggregate is 17, and it was indicated earlier that the value of C4, C5 and C6 is calculated as 4. So we move on to the next result slip, and the social studies is a B3, English language is a C6, core mathematics is A1, integrated science is A1, elective mathematics is a B3, biology is a B2, chemistry is a B2, physics is a C5. So using the minimum entry requirement, the university is going to take the English, the core mathematics, the integrated science and 3 of the elective subject, which sums up to aggregate 13. However, your final aggregate may change based on the program's entry requirement, so please take note of this. Exam sittings and results. The Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology takes a total of 3 exam sittings. The university also accepts all past WASSCE and SSC results. So if you know you wrote WASSCE or SSC in the past, you can use those results to apply. The university also accepts a combination of May, June and NOVDEC results. The university also accepts a combination of WASSCE and SSC results. Awaiting candidates can apply with their past WASSCE or SSC results in addition to their awaiting result. Those who have passed WASSCE and SSC results must indicate the subject and key in their results when applying online. So what this means is that on the application portal, if you have a past WASSCE result, you have to indicate all the subjects you wrote and also indicate the grades that you attained for these subjects when applying online. Selection of program choices. Programs must be selected in order of preference from the very competitive courses to the less competitive courses. So prospective applicants should take note of this in order to stand a chance of gaining admission. Some program requires a specific background elective. So for instance, if you look at programs in the engineering sciences, these programs are only available to pure science students, meaning you must have physics, chemistry, biology, and elective mathematics, and also have some technical background electives. Some programs are also open to all background. So for instance, a program like Bachelor of Law is open to all elective background. Some programs in the College of Health Sciences also requires you to write entrance exams and attend interviews before gaining admission. So some of the programs in the College of Health Sciences is not a straightforward admission, as you must write exams and attend interview before you are finally selected. The cutoff point system at the University of Science and Technology, and it varies from year to year, meaning it is not fixed. It is normally determined by the university board on the performance of the WASSCE May-June results. So when WAEC releases its May-June results, a new cutoff point is set by the University of Science and Technology every year. You should also be mindful that every program has its cutoff
point requirement. For instance, a program like aerospace engineering, the cutoff point for last academic year was aggregate 9. And an additional requirement is that you needed a minimum of a grade B3 in integrated science if you did not have chemistry as an elective. Fee paying also has its cutoff points. Cutoff points may change if you place a competitive program as your second, your third, or your fourth choice. So prospective applicants should also take note of this. Female applicants applying into science, technology, engineering, and mathematics STEM shall gain 1 point aggregate advantage. So STEM is an affirmative action policy set by the University of Science and Technology to encourage females to pursue more of the science and technology based programs. Applicants must take note of these common application errors. Applying with the wrong information details with regards to your biographical data. So your name should be the same as your WAEC result slip when you are applying to the university online portal. Also do well to provide an accurate address where you can be reached or contacted. You should also make sure to provide accurate and active contact details. Always do well to cross-check and confirm your index number when you are applying. You must do well to make sure the correct month of examination is indicated. Your serial number and PIN number must be kept safely. If possible, you can take a picture of it on your phone because it's the same login details you will use to download your admission letter if you are successful. Scanning of documents and proof of citizenship. So you must make sure to scan and upload your birth certificate or any national ID such as your passport or your voter's ID or your health insurance when you are applying online. Incomplete application. So after applying online, always make sure to print your proof of application and make the necessary photocopies of your WAEC results, your birth certificate, to be posted to the university. Endorsement of forms. So you should always make sure your documents and your forms is well endorsed by a higher authority before you post to the University of Science and Technology. So all completed applications should be submitted by post through EMS, DHL, UPS, or FedEx. Moving on to some of the WAEC regulations one must follow. Withheld results from WAEC can also affect your admission to the University of Science and Technology. Know the credibility of your school or any remedial school over the years if a particular school has had bad records of examination malpractices. So you should know about such records before enrolling into any remedial school. Avoid any form of examination malpractices. So applicants should desist from any forms of examination malpractice so that their results will not be affected when released by WAEC. Comply with all the rules and regulations from WAEC. Owing of school fees may also affect your admission, because although the results will be in yours in particular will be frozen due to the school fees you are owing back in school. So please take note of this as well. If you also have disciplinary problems in your school or bad disciplinary records, your admission to the University of Science and Technology can also be affected as well. Application deadlines. Application begins in the month of January 2020 and ends in the month of July 2020. However, the university will give applicants some grace period to review and make changes when WAEC releases its May-June results before the portal is finally closed. Applicants are therefore advised to use this opportunity to make changes with respect to a program they duly qualify for. So when WAEC releases the results, the University of Science and Technology will give applicants a 1 week grace period to make the necessary changes to the application. So assuming you know your final aggregate is now, let's say, aggregate 10, and you applied for law initially as your first choice, and maybe BA political studies as your second choice. Because the results are now in and you know perfectly well you don't qualify for Bachelor of Law, you quickly make sure to make changes and put BA political studies as your first choice because you did not meet the cutoff point for the Bachelor of Law, which is aggregate 6. So my point here is that you make sure you make changes for the program you qualify for. After making changes, applicants must lastly review their application, cross-check their biodata and WAEC index number, month and year of examination before final submission. It is very important to make sure your index number is indicated correctly for the University of Science and Technology to be able to process your application successfully. Admissions list. Successful applicants will receive a text message based on the contact details they provided. If not, they should check for their status on the university website. Download your provisional admission letter by entering your serial number and your PIN details. So always make sure to keep safely your login details so you can download your admission letter in the future. Read carefully the instructions on your admission letter, and when duly satisfied, you can continue to make payment of your fees at the bank. After making payment, be checking from the university website for any new announcement regarding accommodation, orientation, registration, matriculation, and when lectures is going to begin. You may also visit the official University of Science and Technology's website, and the website is apps.knust.edu.dh/admissions/check. The purchase of the University of Science and Technology e-voucher is being sold at 220 cedis. All Ghanaian applicants are required to purchase the e-voucher from any of the national post office. Applicants are required to submit 2 copies of the online application and other relevant documents such as your results and any national identification. All completed applications should be submitted by post through EMS, DHL, UPS or FedEx to the Deputy Registrar, Academic Affairs, KNUST, Kumasi, Ghana on or before the 31st of July 2020. Any hand-delivered application shall not be processed by the University of Science and Technology. Enquiries. Visit the official Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology website for any information needed. And the website is www.knust.edu.gh/admissions/prospective/applying. You may also visit the admissions office at the central administration only for any enquiries or further assistance. The working hours is from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. from Monday to Friday. You may also write an email to the admissions unit, and the email is admissions@knust.edu.gh. You may also contact the admissions unit on phone, and their numbers are 0322-061-831. 0322-060-444. 024-013-0946. 050-048-2807. So I'd like to thank you for watching my videos to the end and gaining new insights on how the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology application and admission process works. In my upcoming videos, we are going to break down the application process into colleges, what are their entry requirements and their cutoff points, so you can also apply wisely to the University of Science and Technology. I thereby encourage you to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. Like this video, comment, ask questions, and most importantly, share to friends and relatives who are also applying this year. Thank you for watching, and see you in my next video.